A warm welcome to all of you and a heartfelt namaste. I, Anuradha Sharda, would like to thank you all for liking the content and for subscribing to the channel. Today, we are going to talk about a beautiful prashna. But before that, if you would like to listen to this audio and many other audios, please do subscribe to our Spotify channel and listen to all the audios that you are wanting to on the go. So when we talk about prashna, as always, I would repeat a few things. Prashna should be very direct. Prashna should be to the point. Prashna should be asked with a very calm mind. And prashna, when you put up a prashna to a person, you should be very specific about what you want to ask. When you know all these things, when you're in a calm state of mind and putting the prashna in a very direct manner, the answers that you get are also forthright, direct. Last but not the least, make sure that your prashna is positive, because once the answer is got, more often than not, prashna is a sure shot weapon in any astrologer's arsenal. So let's move ahead and see what the prashna is about. The prashna is about civil services examination. When we talk about any examination, we definitely need to see the intelligence of a person. The intelligence of a person is seen from the fifth house. The fact whether the person has studied or not is the fourth house. And so all these houses will give us their share of answers. The sixth house tells us our ability to pass any entrance exam. And if you're looking for a job through those entrance examinations, then definitely need to consider the 10th house and the 7th house. Apart from that, the lagna is extremely important. Anywhere, I take it as if all of us know that the lagna is in, be it prashna, be it our daily lives, or be it when we are seeing the kundli for any purpose in a divisional chart, that lagna has to be extremely strong, or for that matter, fairly enough strong for the person to do a better job with that respect. Having said that, let us take one prashna wherein a person came to me with the mind of seeing if something is going to transpire for him in a civil service examination. So when we check out the lagna, we see that the lagna for this person is Capricorn lagna, and Saturn is sitting right there on the lagna and it is retrograde. Now let us go systematically one by one. When we are talking about Saturn, Saturn is the Karmakaraka. It is also related to the government services. It is also aspecting the 10th house of government services in this chart here. And it is sitting in this prashna, and right now also it's sitting right there on Capricorn, which is the sign of commerce. So it's all good signs. And Saturn is retrograde, giving it one of the Shadbalas, that is Cheshtabal, very strong strength with the Lagnesh sitting right there in the Lagna. So as far as our Lagna and Lagnesh was concerned, this criteria is very well fulfilled. Now let's see if the person has been studying. The fourth Lord has gone in the third house. It is a possibility that the person may not have studied a lot. When we see the fifth house, is it possible that the person will be able to sit, is in a position to sit for this competitive exam? Yes, very much so, because the Lagna, fifth Lord, is there with Moon, and the Moon is the Lord of the seventh house of getting a good service. Now, the fifth Lord is Venus, and Venus and Moon both are in Rohini Nakshatra, which says that there's definitely a chance of growth as far as this set of exams are concerned. Now we go back to the Lagna, where I see a retrograde planet. So where a retrograde planet, that is Saturn, that means repetition. And when we are seeing the sixth house, there is the sixth Lord Mercury in Gemini being the sixth house with Rahu. Obviously, Gemini represents a dual sign, which is multiplicative in nature. And apart from that, Mercury, which is the planet of multiplicity, is sitting there with Rahu. And Rahu, we know, expands the quotient, expands whatever the value of a planet it sits with. And if it's sitting in that particular house, definitely much over the house lot, definitely much more. And we see with Mercury, it will definitely expand it exponentially because it is a friend of Mercury's. So he's not sat just for one, but maybe multiple civil service examinations. And he told me that that was the case. Retrograde planets give repetitive results. It is on the Rahu Ketu axis. Mercury is also aspected by a 12th lord, which is Jupiter, sitting in the 12th house, right down the Rahu Ketu axis. And this Jupiter is also retrograde. So there can be a possibility that the person has sat for more than one exams. And as I said, he did. However, he could not pass one of them because you would have to sit again time and time again and then clear one. And he cleared one such exam because the Mercury gave him the intelligence, gave him the brains, and gave him the aptitude, the go-getting attitude to clear one of those exams. Will he get the job? He sure should, because in the seventh house also, we have a strong Saturn, a Sun. And this Sun is aspected by Saturn. The Sun-Saturn combination definitely bodes very good for government jobs and responsibilities. So with this, we can always say that the person would definitely get a government job or would pass through his exams for his civil exams. So definitely the native should have got through, and he did call me up and let me know that he got through his one of these exams that he had sat for. He had sat for two exams. As I said, there is a multiplicity that can be seen, and he had sat for two exams. One exam he could not clear, the other one he managed to clear the prelims of it. So we should be very definite when we're asking a prashna. We should be very, very careful that that prashna relates to a particular thing that we want to know, and it should be positive if we want to get the positive and the correct answer. Till we meet with you again, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share the videos. Thank you so much.